With the continuation of the previous video, we will look on the relays. So relays, what is relay? We already we have certain introduction about relays by electrical department, electrical devices and control. We can know about what is meant by relays. The electrical relays offer simply on off switching action in response to a signal issued by a control system. If a control system gives the power to the relay starts to energize and it starts to open or close or on or off the circuit. So this is the purpose of the relays. In other words, the relays are nothing but electrically operated switches. Usually we operate mechanically. Mechanically, you know that in house itself we have switches. It is operated manually. The same way, the relays is a device used to on off the switches automatically. That means by means of electricity. So we have a operating principle. We have tension spring here. We have an arm here. Here we have the breaking. We have no contact and we have contact. Here we have an electromagnetic coil. If you switch on this low voltage, it energizes this coil. So automatically this coil become electromagnet. So when the electromagnet is actuated, automatically it pulls this relay arm. So automatically it starts to attract and the circuit is contacted. Then it through this the high voltage is passing. Here the current is flow, high voltage current is flow. So when the contact is established, the automatically high voltage current is passing through the circuit. So the, normally the relay coil is mentioned by CR. CR means it is coil relay. We usually mentions the letter called CR. So this is a symbol for relay coil. And it is normally open contacts. Usually the contact is open. So this is a normally closed coil. So actually if this two is attached, then it is called as normally closed. Now it is normally open. Now it is open condition. When if you want to close this, if you give the electromagnet, then it starts to close. If normally closed coil means the both of this is in closed condition. So if you want, if you energize the electromagnetic coil, it pulls this and automatically it starts to open. So this is the electrically operated relay switches sort of function. So normally open contacts, normally closed coil circuit. So this is the symbol for that. You just remember this symbol. Why I am taking electrical control system today is because we are going with a large fluidics, a fluid logic control systems. So where we use the relays, the pressure switches, push buttons. So when you want to understand such diagrams, you must have this introduction. That's why I am giving some introduction on electrical pneumatic circuits. And we have timers and time delayers. These things are used to calculate the timing in the circuits. Timers also known as time delay relays are time delay switches used to control the time duration of working cycle. So this is used in the many pneumatic circuits where we have to calculate the time. The timer is used if we know that the operating procedures and we know that what is the time is required for a given operation. If operation is operated in 10 seconds, then we can use the timers. So timers automatically records the time. So after 10 seconds, the solenoid valve or other relay coil starts to operate. So that if you want a circuit based on timing, this timers and time delay relays are used. So this is also by means of we have time closed with energized, normally open, normally closed. So when energized, then it starts to close. So if de-energized, then automatically it starts to open. That is the normally open condition. So it is all about for predetermined time interval. We know that in industry itself they have process planning. In process planning itself, they know that what is the time is required to do an operation. If this operation is done within a stipulated time, they will know that. So within this time, we can operate. So they set the time. So based on the timing, the time delays is actuated. So then we will go with ladder diagrams. So far we have discussed about electro-hydraulic and electro-pneumatic circuits, the basic fundamental components, push buttons, limit switches, pressure switches, temperature switches, solenoids, relays and timers. So based on this, how they are construct the ladder diagram. So ladder, we know that usually if you translate into Tamil, what is ladder? It is Eni. It is used to step up and step down in a stairs, upstairs and downstairs. So ladder diagram is a construction, it's a representation for the electrical devices used in a circuit. It is used to mention and notify, or it used to self-explanation about a circuit. It shows that what are all the electrical devices, electrical switches, electrical control devices used in a circuit. A ladder diagram is a representation of hardware connection between switches, relays, solenoids, that is electrical control devices, which constitute the basic components of an electrical control systems. In other words, ladder diagram is nothing but electrical diagram. So that is what I have told, electrical diagram showing the hardware connection between various electrical control devices. We are only talking about the electrical control devices. It's like a circuit diagram in electrical devices and control. We already studied, and you have went to a lab where we have a circuit diagram. Similarly, in hydraulics and pneumatics, we have ladder diagram in order to explain the electrical control devices. Here we have ladder diagram details. The ladder diagram, I show the picture. It is the picture of ladder diagram where we have two sides. These two sides is called as legs, and it is connected horizontally with the lines. This is called as rungs. It constitutes lungs, rungs and legs. In this legs, the leftmost side, left side, shows where the current is flowing, the alternative current or direct current flows. And in right hand side, it is the neutral or ground is connected. And here it is connected with the electrical control components. So here we have two legs. Here and one control switch is available, the start button is available. When the start button is actuated, then it flows the current. So here one limit switch is, we have a limit switch. This limit switch normally opens. So when the limit switch is actuated, it energizes solenoid valve A. The solenoid valve is connected with the direction control valve. So direction control valve and all the those diagram, those details is not given here. We have only have the electrical components such as limit switch and solenoid valve. So then if limit switch 2 is energized, the 2 is activated, then solenoid B starts to energize. So this is the difference between the limit switch 1, and if limit switch 1 is connected with solenoid valve A and limit switch 2 is connected with the solenoid B. So if these things is coupled, then automatically these things gets energized. So these are all things used in the simple circuit. So it is a representation to show that electrical control components in a circuit. So with this, the ladder diagram is completed. We will look in another video about fluidics. So with this video is complete. So far we have discussed about electrical control components and what is the ladder diagram. So for ladder diagrams, we have the electrical pneumatic circuits. So that part we'll discuss later. So importantly, to show